Hey babies, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. Now's a good time to go ahead and subscribe. We are teaming up with Prizms to bring you this 5-in-1 curling iron. It is interchangeable. Of course, all the details and hopefully a coupon code will be listed down in my description box below if you want to check that out. Y'all, this is like a completely new unboxing for me. I decided to kind of just do this on camera, like a real first time kind of review type of deal. So you're welcome. Okay. Nevertheless, when you open the package, of course, you get that heat protecting glove. And then, of course, everything is nicely stored into this kind of roll up bag. You get the bottom part, which obviously is the main mechanism. It has, of course, the heat controls, the on and off button. It is digital, which I love. And then it kind of locks in and out of place. So you guys can kind of see that where you'll turn it to kind of lock it and to be able to exchange them. So this is what the 5 different switches look like, or switches. Irons, I should say, look like. Of course, they vary in size. Typically, I would go for maybe about a 1 inch to maybe even a 2 inch to get a deep wave look. But in this case, you guys, what I decided I was going to do is to use this bumpy one. I was actually going to purchase one a while ago. This was perfect. Super duper easy to actually just snap on and go. You just want to make sure that bottom part is not facing the digital area. I don't know that I'm explaining that correctly, but when you see it, you'll be able to just snap it into place and it'll be really easy. Turn on the button and it goes all the way up to 450. I actually use this, I think, on 350, if I'm not mistaken, just because I realized, like, you don't need that much heat. Not all of the time, right? So of course, all the hair details I will list for you as well. I actually got this from a hair company, but this is not what that video is about, so I don't want to focus too much on that. The details will be listed down in my description if you guys want any kind of details about that. Obviously, I made the wig, so it's kind of a plug-in for myself, but Forever Chrissy Wigs, go ahead and check that out if you have not already. But I'm going to go ahead and pretty much put on this glove just to protect my hand. It does have, or the curling iron does have, you know, like that black kind of protective plastic area that prevents you from actually getting burnt at the tip. So I do appreciate that. But what I love even more is that they still gave you a glove just for the extra protection. So that is lovely. Of course, the wig is already kind of laid into place, you guys. So from here, all that I'm going to be doing is sectioning out the hair, and then I'm going to kind of see what I need to do. I've never used this iron before, so I wasn't sure if the hair is supposed to go over the bubbles, if it's supposed to go in between the bubbles. Like, I didn't even look at any tutorials just because I wanted to really give you guys a realistic kind of view, I guess, of like what it is that I'm doing and what my experience was like. So after I actually did this video, y'all, I did go back and look, and I don't think I was doing it right. I don't even think they were doing it right. I don't know. So what I did figure out, though, throughout this video is pretty much it's a lot easier to go ahead and just loop the hair in between the actual bubbles, right? So you guys can kind of watch the video and get a feel for what it is that I mean. You'll get more of like a romantic type of curl than you would more of like a wand curl type of look. So, you know, the wand curls can look really stiff sometimes. Although they brush out really pretty, it's just too uniform. By the end of this, you guys will kind of see what I mean by that romance curl. So, of course, if you're one of those people that just want to kind of watch, I'm going to shut up now, continue this process, try to figure it out, see what it is that I'm doing, and I will be right back to kind of close out. right, babe. So, I don't know about you guys, but I already was in love. And as you guys can see, I took some pretty large sections. Just took a little bit of my Paul Mitchell. I believe this was a skinny serum, just to kind of give it a little bit of shine. It was actually time to wash this unit. But nevertheless, you guys, look at how soft and wavy the curls look. Like, I didn't even brush out that side yet, and it already looks so good. So definitely leave any comments or questions down below. Thank you guys so much for watching, subscribing, all that good stuff. Let me know what you feel about it. Right now, I like it. I love it. I'll definitely be reusing this curling iron again. Hopefully, it'll be a better run through the next time, but we'll see. Y'all know how this go. Down below, comment Sunflower Gang if you've been here, if you are new here. Again, welcome. I love you guys so much. Stay pretty. I will see you in my next video. Bye, babies.